But yet there's still no federal mandate. Are the case numbers and deaths going to continue to surge in this country unless everyone starts wearing a mask, doctor?
Yes. And look, if you want schools open in the fall, and if you want college football in the fall, you know, the vice president desperately wants college football in the fall, then mandate masks. Tell everyone they have to wear a mask. Ramp up the testing. Let's double the testing over the next 2 weeks. Yeah, and then you have a chance to have schools open in October. We have football season starting in October. We can start to get back to closer to normal. It's if you ask a parent to choose between having your kid wear a mask at school or keeping them home for the next year, what do you think they're going to choose? It's mind-boggling. I just don't understand it.
I don't get, what is the logic? What is he waiting on? Like, how many people, doctor, honestly, have to die? How much more evidence does he need about masks and other things that he's doing wrong, that he's getting wrong? I don't understand what he's waiting on. He's just incapable, maybe.
You know, there was a story in the New York Times last week. They took CDC death data. All the deaths are reported to the CDC. And they looked at deaths in the United States between March 15th and July 25th of this year, and compared it to the comparable periods from the last 3 years. And there have been about 205,000 excess deaths in the United States. So you can account for about 160,000+ confirmed COVID positive cases. But that means there are at least another 45,000 people who have died either from COVID or from collateral damage, people having heart attacks, not going to the hospital, strokes. So the real mortality has been about 205,000 people. Not 165, 205,000. And it's going to go up.
Wow. Daniel, the president was asked about how he's considering an executive order requiring health insurers to cover pre-existing conditions, something that Obamacare already does. Listen to this.
We want to be able to assure people that pre-existing condition is always taken care of. As you know, we've done tremendous things having to do with the individual mandate. We got rid of the individual mandate from Obamacare, which really ended Obamacare as it would be officially known, because the individual mandate was the biggest part. It was also the most unpopular part, where you pay for a terrible privilege of overpaying for insurance.
Does he know anything he's talking about? Well, give me the fact check, Daniel.
So a couple of things here, Don. First of all, ending the individual mandate did not effectively, essentially end Obamacare. The protections for people with pre-existing conditions remain in existence in that law. So does the Medicaid expansion. So do the exchanges where people can buy health insurance. So do the subsidies that are provided through the Affordable Care Act to help some people buy health insurance. Second of all, Trump says that his executive order will provide a sense of security for people with pre-existing conditions. Well, again, that's much less security than the ACA, a law, provides. And Trump's administration, he doesn't like to talk about this that much, but his administration is in court supporting a Republican lawsuit to get the entirety of Obamacare declared unconstitutional, Don.
And yet people will vote against their own interests because they don't really know what is going on. They're listening to him. Flat out lies, right to your face. Thank you, gentlemen. Appreciate it. I want to get now to